standing here in my vegetable garden, and about the middle of the garden I have a row of strawberries, which you've seen in some previous videos. And immediately following harvest, within about 7 to 10 days, you want to go through a process called renovation. Now, if you look at the strawberries as they go through the season, they'll develop a number of leaf diseases, some in the spring, and it continues on into the fall. But the purpose of renovation is to remove some of that diseased materials and to renew the beds. And the time that we do that, as I mentioned before, is shortly after harvest, usually within about 10 days. Now, if you're growing your strawberries on what's called a matted row system, which means your beds are up to 2 feet wide and it's a matted row, essentially, like a small ground cover, eventually those plants will continue to reproduce to the point to where there's so much crowding and competition for food and nutrients that the plants will produce inferior fruit. So we need to renovate the beds by taking our lawnmower, setting it at the highest settings, and go right over the top and mow the berries. And the purpose of this is to remove the leaves, and this will stimulate the plant to produce additional runners, and then they spread and produce more daughter plants, and thereby renewing the bed with more productive plants. As the crowns get older, they become less productive. So if you were to do nothing, the bed would become less and less productive over time. Usually within about three or four years, you'll start to see some real decrease in yields. Now, my system here, I have a planting of strawberries that are spaced in the row at 12 inches, and I can't run over this with a lawnmower. So what I normally will do for renovation is to use some hand shears and cut them down by hand. Now, I mentioned the reason why we use the lawnmower and set it on the highest setting is because you don't want to destroy the crowns. If you do that, then you defeated the purpose of the whole process of renovating the bed. The other thing that should be done is, if you have a rototiller, you should narrow those beds down to about 10 to 12 inches. And those mother plants will then start to send out new daughter plants, fill in that row again with nice, healthy plants that will be productive. Now, you may also need to go in and take out some occasional really old mother plants in that 10 to 12 inches if they're still too close together. This is also the time that we put fertilizer on the plants, and we use a rate of 5 pounds of a balanced fertilizer, like 10-10-10 or 12-12-12 per 100 foot of row. Now, if you're using an organic fertilizer, you're obviously going to have to use more in order to get the same nutrient content. And you don't have to worry about burning plants when you're using organic fertilizers. So adding more won't make a difference like it would with a chemical fertilizer. Once the crowns have been mowed down, this is a good time to get any perennial plants, i.e. weeds, out before you fertilize. And after fertilization, you should water immediately so that you can work that fertilizer into the soil. And you should water usually once to twice a week. About an inch of water a week should be put on to get those plants up and going again pretty quickly. Now, some people like to use mulch around their strawberries in order to keep the weeds down. But when those runners start to run out and the daughter plants want to root into the soil, if you have a thick cover of straw mulch, they will root in the straw, and a daughter plant cannot survive on its own unless it has rooted in the soil. So it's a good idea to keep that mulch back until the daughter plants have a chance to get established into the soil, and then you can put the soil or the mulch back around the plants. Another thing you should do is rake all the dead leaves out, or the leaves that you just mowed, and put them in your compost pile. Don't leave them laying around. And then, of course, you can reintroduce it after it's composted down completely as a soil amendment if you want to. As mentioned in an earlier video, one of the reasons we fertilize strawberries at renovation is not only to get the plants up and going well, but we do not want to introduce large amounts of nitrogen early in the spring. If we do that, it'll result in soft berries, and you will not be too happy with the quality. I hope this has been helpful, and thank you for all your comments and for watching. This is Gary Heilig signing out.